Teachers make level of achievement decisions by looking at the on-balance decisions they have made for each of the dimensions or objectives, and then they will look at the syllabus to see whether the student responses match to a particular level of achievement. The level of achievements, VLA through to VHA, are decided, and the minimum requirements for awarding a level of achievement are that a student will, for example, for an HA, have to receive two Bs, or a B in two different dimensions, and then no less than a C in the third dimension. So that gives advice to the teacher about how to make their level of achievement decision.
Well, I guess if we start firstly with the big decision about which level of achievement this particular folio matches with, and as you said, you've identified there is an A in criterion 1, a B in criterion 2, and an A in criterion 3. And if we go to the syllabus, the minimum requirements for an exit level clearly meets VHA requirements.
Yep,
two standard A's, one standard B. So we've got a VHA.
We have a VHA, and so the question really is the relative placement within that particular band.
Sure.
And whether we're dealing with the low VHA.
Mm-hmm.
Teachers will make relative achievement decisions by looking at the on-balance judgments they have made in each of the dimensions.
The first decision is to determine the level of achievement. So, for example, I've determined that it's at a B standard. And then I'll be looking, I guess, for, if I'm looking at Form R6, it's not based on a single piece of assessment, it's based on a folio of work. And so if I was looking at a student to be placed high within that band, I would expect to be seeing some evidence of some work at an A standard. So I'd be looking through the folio within the different pieces of assessment for examples of work that met some of the A standard requirements. Similarly, if it was low within that B or HA band, then I'd be looking that perhaps there might be some deficiencies, some areas where it met the work was more characteristic of a C standard. But what we'd like to do is to use the standards to try to differentiate between these two students to see if we can differentiate between their position within that HA band using the standards and the work that we can find in their folio. I think probably we should start with the EEI because that assesses all three general objectives and so would probably give us a good starting point. So if you've got we look at the student there, we can see there's a fair bit of work there that indicates that it's at a B standard and some that it's at the A. So if we look there, say in KCU, the sorts of thing that we're looking for is complex and challenging knowledge and conceptual understanding. And I think we can see some evidence in here because there's work that clearly goes beyond what they've done in class and there's some multi-step processing of that. So from there, if we compare that to this EEI, which also indicates a B standard, but that the student has got some work that's more at a C standard, when we look at the explanation of knowledge and conceptual understanding here, we see it's much more superficial. Would you agree?
Yes, the quality of work that is presented in this particular student compared to that one, I think that the descriptors from the A standards of complex and challenging, as well as linking of algorithms and finding solutions, we can clearly identify them in this work. Whereas in that particular piece of work, it's more tenuous. In other words, I think that there are some circumstances where we can find some complexity. There is a little bit of work that has gone a little beyond perhaps the classroom information, but I wouldn't describe this as complex and challenging.
So then if we looked at across a number of tasks, then perhaps we'd hope to see that reflected in the standards that have been demonstrated across a variety of tasks. And so again, we see here, again, while the majority of the work seems to be at a B standard, there's certainly a considerable amount of evidence that that's at an A standard. Whereas, on the other hand, we look at this work again, the majority of the work is at B standard. There's quite good evidence that the knowledge, conceptual understanding and the IP are at the B standard. But there's also certainly a certain amount where they've only demonstrated the C standard. They've met the minimum requirements for the HA standard, but because of that C, we'd indicate it being at the low end of the range.
Yes.
the work in this folio seems to be primarily, again, the bulk of evidence is at the B standard, but there's a number of occasions where the student has achieved the A standard, which would suggest that they're B at the higher end of the HA range.
Well, I've got a slightly better student, and this one has certainly got the same sort of area, but you can see that in knowledge and procedures there's some A's, B's, A, B, and a B's. You could argue somewhere between an A and a B, but I'd probably say it's closer to a B than an A. So in the knowledge and procedures, I'd be really looking at a B. However, as we go up into the knowledge, to the modelling and problem solving, you can see that the student's work has shown more consistently an A standard. There's a few times where they're actually a B, B here, but an A. There's three of the instruments here have actually shown an A sort of standard. So I'd be happy for an A minus in that particular area. In communication justification, almost entirely the B standards come through. So if I look at this particular one, we're talking about a B in knowledge and procedures, an A in modelling and problem solving, and a B in communication justification. If that was the case, I'd be looking at a high B. Perhaps not right on the 10, perhaps 8 or 9 to deal with that.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's reasonable based on those criteria sheets. Yes, Peter?
Okay. Good.
Okay.
So what do we do in terms of placing criterion 2, the whole folio with reference to the evidence in criterion 2? Mm-hmm. We know it can't be a mid-range VHA, don't we?
It's not mid-range, but it's not absolutely threshold either.
No, okay.
Because, you know, I think there is sufficient evidence in criterion 2, which is the contentious one, to show that the student isn't really just hanging in on the edge, the very, very bare minimum.
Well, there are some A qualities in that particular dimension and criterion, aren't there? So we need to recognise that with reference to the placement.
So I would be thinking somewhere on about VH2 is my sense of what the evidence is telling me at this point in time.
Yep, I could support that, and I could certainly see that it's not threshold. It is lower than typical, and it's certainly somewhere in that range. Mm-hmm. So I think that's a good decision.
Yep.
It's important that teacher judgments are consistent. Consistency requires teachers to have professional conversations with other teachers so that they develop shared understandings, they use student responses, and talk about the match to the standards.
The professional conversations that teachers have in reaching agreement about student achievement ensure that judgments are reliable, consistent, transparent, and fair.